so much of what makes college athletics great, a lot of the fans think that that's going to start dissipating. That's going to start going away with the advent of NIL. I happen to disagree with that, but that's just my opinion. I want yours. What impact, if any, do you think NIL is going to have on, say, the sanctity of the sport, the purity of the sport, the nostalgia and the feeling that even the players have about the sport and commitment to a program? You could even throw in there the open transfer, how guys can just, you know, go on a whim. Do you think any of that or all of that takes away from what you have always thought makes college football special?
No, not at all. I think that, you know, people want to talk about this now and kind of put it on the players. It's going to mess up, you know, college football and so forth. Listen, the NCAA and these coaches, they've messed college football up. They've been making the money they've been making on these players for so long. Yes, you do get an education, you do get a degree and all that. Yeah, I could go get a degree anytime I want. I can go pay for that. You know what I mean? My point is that the amount of money that these coaches have made, the amount of money these universities have made on the backs of these players, and these players haven't been able to get anything, me personally, I don't think it's fair. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, whatever college football ends up being, it's not on the player. They created this. You know what I mean? And so as far as the transfer portal and all that, you know, a lot of people get upset about that. I don't, you know, because, you know, being a player that was highly recruited and coming from a family where I had brothers that all played Division I and all of us are highly recruited, we've sat and had so many coaches come in our living rooms and listen to them and listen to coaches talk about, you know, listen, we're going to be the best for your son. We're going to do this and that. We're going to make sure he, you know, this and that. And then that coach ends up leaving to go somewhere else a week later. You know what I mean? I've had, you know, people come in our house and just lie to us like that. You know, a story about my younger brother. That's why he ended up in Notre Dame. He wanted to go to Northwestern. He was adamant he wanted to go to Northwestern. And I was like, you can't go there. I said, you know, Barnett, the coach at the time, I was like, he's leaving, dude. He is going to leave. He came in the house. He said he's not leaving. He's going to stay. Grant, I promise you, he's leaving. You know, and granted, going to Notre Dame, he ended up leaving. He went to what, Colorado?
Colorado, yeah.
You know what I mean? So my point is, and I don't begrudge coach for doing that or any coach to do that, but that's the system.
We know that Michigan is recruited from a disadvantage when it comes to, they compete with a lot of teams that cheat. Just point blank.
Yeah.
For years have cheated, right? And Michigan was unwilling to do that. But with NIL, it just feels like it levels the playing field in a way that has never, not that it makes it completely level because teams are still going to cheat, but I don't think that the ability to compete with the teams that cheat has ever been greater than it is now based on NIL, based upon Michigan's strong alumni network with guys like you, mm-hmm. you know, executives, CEOs, entrepreneurs. I mean, Michigan's portfolio is so much greater. Am I being too optimistic when I say
no, not at all.
This levels the playing field more than ever?
Well, it levels the playing field with us as a program that have all with tradition and has all the money and backing of a Texas. But we had that tradition where, look, we're Michigan. We're not gonna, you know, mm-hmm. we're not gonna step that fine line or this and that. Now that it's becoming legal, then now we can compete. Yes, we can play on that level. So yes, I do agree with that. It's gonna hurt the smaller programs. That's mm-hmm. what it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt the teams that don't have the funds or the tradition or the name to be able to garner those type of funds to be able to get these players. Mm-hmm. I mean, so I think that's what it's gonna hurt. It's gonna probably create a whole different league. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's gonna be kind of like the, you know, the have and have nots.
Yeah, what if we could buy number 37 Jarrett Irons jerseys back in 95, man?
I know, I need to talk to MD, man. Let's get some retros.